Abraham coming at you again. Just want 5 minutes of your time. Today I want to talk about, you already know, mental health. What's up, everybody? It's Abraham coming at you again. Just want 5 minutes of your time. Today I want to talk about, you already know, mental health. And I want to talk about one of the lessons that I've learned when it comes to our mental health and overcoming adversity and overcoming really dark periods of our lives, dark seasons of our lives. It's inevitable. The darkness that we experience in life, no one is going to be able to grow through life without experiencing these dark times, without experiencing depression in whatever capacity. For me, it was severe symptoms of depression to where I was diagnosed and was put on medication, had to do therapy for some time. For others, it may be minor depression, but whatever bout of depression we experience, there's something that we can learn from it. And from my own experience, I was able to learn 5 steps. And these are the 5 steps that I want to share with you guys today to hopefully give you some clarity, hopefully give you some understanding for the next time you experience that bout of depression or you experience any adversity in your life, you can apply these 5 steps and kind of help yourself out of that adversity. So the first step, and it can be the most difficult one because, like myself, so many of you guys are control freaks. So the first step is to control what you can control. There's so many things that happen in life. There's so many things that occur, and there are certain things that we have control over, and there are also things that we do not have control over. So the reality is, we can't control everything. We can't, like, it's just impossible. We can't control everything. But we get caught up sometimes and we fall into these bouts of depression and we stay stuck and we face these periods of our lives where we can't move forward because we're focusing on the things that are outside of our control. So the first step with overcoming depression or adversity is to control what you can control. What can you control? You can control your actions. You can control your perspective. You can control your attitude. You can control your mindset, whether you have a fixed or growth mindset. These are some of the things that we can control. Now, unfortunately, you can't snap your fingers and suddenly be out of that adversity or suddenly no longer be depressed. Now, we can't control when and how it happens, but we do have full control over what we do in the midst of the adversity. The second step is to take it easy on yourself. And I'm speaking to myself, like, it's so easy sometimes to beat ourselves up when we face difficult times. It's so easy to beat ourselves up when for some reason we can't fight this depression or we can't fight this adversity. And we're wondering to ourselves, well, I've been through harder stuff than this. What is it, you know, with this thing that I can't go through? What is it that I can't overcome? And we tend to beat ourselves up. We tend to call ourselves names like, yo, you're weak or you're dumb or you're stupid or whatever the case is. But the second step to overcoming adversity and or any mental illness, depression, you must take it easy on yourself. You have to be your cheerleader. You're gonna have to be the person that lifts you up even when you're down. Step number three is to prepare. I'll say one more time. Step number three is to prepare. So many of you guys are going after these visions, these goals, these ambitions, or even just overcoming this adversity, but you're not preparing. So once you hit rock bottom, one of the main things that you have to think about is, how can I prepare in a way that I've never prepared before that can allow me to overcome? So the step number three, this is very important. You have to prepare for what it is that you want. You have to prepare in where you are to achieve the goal that you have for yourself. Step number four. I hope you guys ready. You guys stay with me. Step number four is to find an accountability partner. Now, this can be a pastor, this can be your spouse, this can be a good friend of yours. Whoever this person is, you have to find someone who's willing to motivate you when you can't find motivation. Like for me, while I was depressed, while I was struggling with disbelief, while I went to God and I'm like, yo, God, I believe, but help my unbelief. When I was struggling on a cord and couldn't find, you know, my way through what I was going through, I had to rely on the belief that others had of me. I had to rely on the belief of my accountability partners. I had to rely on the belief from my therapist, from my close friends, from my family members, who believe that I can overcome this, until I was able to build my own belief. So it's very important to find an accountability partner that can help you get to where you want to go. And step number five, and we all know this to be true because we've heard it, you know, from historical figures. We've heard it from some of the greats, and it's simple. Step number five is to never give up. You have to get to a point where it registers in your mind that no matter what adversity you face, no matter how dark it can be, no matter how lonely and alone and desperate you may be, make up in your mind that you will never give up. No matter what, never give up. I had to look myself in the mirror sometimes and say to myself, yo, you will never give up. I will never give up. I want you to repeat after me. I will never give up. I will never give up. I will never give up. And I had to be that person in my life to give myself the positive self-talk in order to overcome depression, in order to overcome this adversity that I face in my life. So I share with you guys these five steps, and my hope is that you will apply these five steps in every and any area of your life where you feel stuck. Any area of your life where you feel depressed, where you feel down, where you're facing some sort of adversity. Remember, the first step is to control what you can control. The second step is to take it easy on yourself. The third step is to prepare, get in preparation mode. The fourth step is to find an accountability partner. And step number five is to never give up. So I hope this was inspiring for you. I hope this was, you know, some practical steps that you can apply to your life. And I will see you next time. Peace.